welcome to Tile TV. I'm your host, Michelle. Over 28,000 industry professionals attended Covering 17, held earlier this month in Orlando, Florida. Coverings is the leading event for tile and stone in the Americas, and this year enjoyed a 9% increase in total attendance from 2016 in Chicago. Over 90 countries were represented at this international event, with 1,100 exhibitors using over 465,000 square feet of convention hall space to showcase the newest products and technology in tile and stone. The National Tile Contractors Association, one of the owners of Coverings, was pleased to announce that contractor and installer attendance at the show was up 36% from 2016 in Chicago. The NTCA, which also co-sponsored a NASCAR simulated race car, had two booths that were packed throughout the four-day event, netting over 30 new members who joined the association. Planning is already underway for Coverings 2018, which will move to Atlanta, Georgia, taking place May 8th through the 11th at the Georgia World Congress Center. At a special awards ceremony at Coverings, the NTCA celebrated 70 years of leadership in the tile and stone industry, honoring two of its longtime members. David Allen Company and Artcraft Granite Marble and Tile were both presented with awards for their contributions to the association over the years. David Allen Company of Raleigh, North Carolina is a founding member of the NTCA, and Artcraft Granite Marble and Tile, formerly of El Paso, Texas, and now located in Mesa, Arizona, joined not long after. The David Allen Company has had four company representatives serve as president of the association, and Butch and James Wellfell of Artcraft GMT are the only father and son combination to serve that capacity. Also at the award ceremony, the NTCA honored current president Martin Howard of the David Allen Company as its Tile Person of the Year. Finally, the association recognized Crossville Tile and the MAPE Corporation for supporting the NTCA and the Gary Sinise Rise Foundation, providing tile and installation materials in adaptable smart homes built for American heroes wounded while serving our country. Please stay tuned for more after this from our sponsor. Welcome back. In almost every tile industry specification and tile or installation manufacturer product warranty, they mention that the substrate must be free of dust and contaminants. Manufacturers are trying to make sure that a chemical or mechanical bond will take place between the proper adhesive and the recommended substrate. Often, the focus of this concern, and rightfully so, centers on the actual substrate for which the tile will be installed on. However, there are times when the back of the tile surface can contribute to an installation failure, and it's important that the tile or flooring contractor is aware of this potential pitfall in our trade. Tile manufacturers often use a release agent on the back of their tile to allow tiles to move through the kiln at a high temperature and not stick together. This release agent is referred to as clay ongobe. Usually, the manufacturer removes this from the tiles at the factory. However, we are aware of some instances where this material makes its way onto the field. Since it is often recommended to wet the backs of the tile with a sponge to remove dust, you would think that this would also work on the release agent. However, it has been found that this material, while white or chalky, is commonly very difficult to remove in the field and is certainly a potential bond breaker. One NTCA distributor and contractor member who worked in a project claimed that they ordered thousands of square feet of 12 by 12, 6 by 12, and 24 by 24 material. They found ongobe material on the back of only one of the sizes, and all pieces in that size were what did not bond to the substrate. It is good practice to always examine the back of the tile before you begin the installation. If you find ongobe on the back of the tile and it does not come off easily with a sponge or wire brush, you can either ask to have it tested by an independent laboratory like the Tile Council of North America for bond performance, or you can reject the material and ask for a replacement that does not have the release agent on the back of the tile. It is hard enough for a tile contracting company to do everything right to ensure a successful installation. Nothing can be more frustrating than to have a bond failure take place because either the tile surface or substrate contains contaminants. Thanks for watching this episode of Tile TV. We'll be back soon, so stay tuned.